Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us live for this month's episode of Ram Life Entertainment. We are where we are enriching the Fort Collins community one episode at a time. I'm Courtney Fromm.
And I'm Vinny Sangaline.
It is November officially. It feels like the semester has flown by.
I know, right? No Shave November.
Yes, you're rocking it. Do you know what comes, you know what's in November, Vinny?
The cold, not much.
What else? It's my birthday!
Oh, yeah! Yay!
I'm so excited. But I think Rocky Mountain Student Media forgot it was my birthday because I didn't make the birthday board. I was a little upset about it, but it's
That's
okay.
That's not good.
But yeah, we've got a lot planned ahead, and we're both got...
I know, Thanksgiving break.
Yes.
We have a break coming up.
And we've got quite the adventure after the semester, which we'll get to later in the show.
Yes.
So Trump won.
Trump did win. I don't think... You know, I mean...
It was unexpected, I think, from left field.
Unexpected, yeah.
But I think we're going to keep it positive, get it going, and we're going to see how this ends up turning out.
It was, you know, a heck of a race. Both candidates did a great job.
Yes, they did. I completely agree. And the public spoke.
The people have spoken.
The people have spoken.
Yes.
So, on a more local note, earlier this week, students were able to participate in fall cleanup.
Yes, I actually had the honor of participating. I got to go clean up this little old lady's house, and I was honored to do it.
Fall is in the air, and leaves are on the ground.
Oh, it's a great morning, and I mean, the sun's shining, and the birds are chirping, and it's a great fall day.
Colorado State University students worked together on Saturday to help people in Fort Collins with their fall chores.
Go around the community and go clean, like, rake yards or clean out gutters and just help out people that need help.
And that is exactly what CSU Polo member Andrew Wildermuth spent his Saturday doing.
Fall cleanup would be a great way to help the community and give back and then also get our community service hours. So we have a lot of the CSU Polo teammates here and we're all just working hard and...
Working hard and having fun, a tradition at CSU that's been going on for a couple years.
I feel like that's one of the very unique things about CSU is that it's like a very community very big community with not only the students, but with like the elderly and everyone else who just lives in Fort Collins.
From raking leaves and cleaning gutters, community members are very thankful for their CSU Rams.
Today we're helping out this old lady and I think her husband. And
reminding us just how lucky we are to live in the beautiful Fort Collins, Colorado.
I would say come out and help. Just because you're in a club doesn't mean you can't come out and help with fall cleanup. CSU needs help and I'm sure like people in the community would love for you to come rake their yard or mow their lawn. It doesn't matter. Just helping out like is just a great part to...
I know I had a blast, and it was just great to help the community.
Fall, I could say, is in full swing, and I have been able to continue my Beer 101 classes with flavors perfect for the season. Brewers, including both Upslope and Great Divide, made a fun class with a few freebies. Don't forget tomorrow night at 7 p.m. at the Mayor of Old Town to join me in these classes. Check out all my Beer 101 classes each week in the Collegian, or you can check it out on thecollegian.com under the blog section. Speaking of beer, the Mayor of Old Town has given me the opportunity to create relationships with other beer-minded individuals in the Fort Collins community. One in particular is a local shop at the Craft Beer Cellar, excuse me. Owners Justin and Chris have not only become friends of mine, but have taught me the lesson of expired beer.
Have you ever purchased a bad beer that tasted like this?
Two things you gotta look out for, wet cardboard and skunk.
Neither sounding appetizing. Luckily, Justin Wright, co-owner of the local craft beer cellar in Fort Collins, told us how these elements can show up into your beer.
Their oxidation, which is in a lot of lighter beers, it's like a papery cardboard flavor. So if you've ever been around wet cardboard, that's what it tastes like. It's terrible, right?
And what about that skunk smell?
If you have a beer out in sunlight or in a lighter bottle like clear, green, blue, those will get light struck, which tastes like the same exact smell a skunk smells like.
This all can be avoided by one simple thing.
In addition, I think just freshness of beer is a big deal.
Freshness that is controlled by your place of purchase. Chris Lazzari, who is also a co-owner of the craft beer cellar, explains what makes their store different from the rest.
Look on the window as you walk in, it says amazing beer, hospitality, and education. That's not just there for show, that is what we're all about. We have, in my opinion, the best selection in town, if not the state of Colorado.
Not only selection, but both Chris and Justin are certified Cicerones that know exactly what it takes to serve the best quality beer to their customers.
We work all day on Monday, and we do something called QC Monday, which is quality control. So we will just randomly test stuff and make sure everything is tasting great.
And they also get to decide what beers they want to sell at their store.
We have a fantastic relationship with many, many breweries in town here. Yeah, we're all great friends, and we have an exclusive section here in our store that we are the only store in Fort Collins to carry about a dozen to a dozen and a half different breweries. And we either pick them up ourselves, or they know our store, they know our concept, and they bring their beers only to us.
Located on the corner of Mason and Mountain in Old Town, Justin and Chris want college students at CSU to come and check it out.
What a good time to live when kids that are 21 know good beer already, and they come to us to help get their education on and try new stuff, and that's really cool to see.
Justin and Chris are looking into a possible student discount for the future, but they want you to come in and check it out. They're more than happy to give you some guidance on your beer purchase.
When we come back, I'll get an exclusive interview with the star of CSU's Fairy Tale Drag Show.
Tune in to KCSU, your student-run radio station at Colorado State University. Live 24 hours a day, every day at 90.5 FM and KCSUFM.com. Live local new music now, and news, talk, and sports. KCSU, the radio voice of Colorado State, on the air since 1964.
You're watching CTV, produced by Colorado State University students, bringing you news, weather, sports, and entertainment from campus and beyond. CTV live Monday through Thursday at 7 p.m. on campus and Fort Collins on Channel 11. Repeats at midnight, 8 a.m., noon, and 2 p.m.
The Rocky Mountain Collegian is your student-run news and information platform. Pick up your paper on campus or around Fort Collins Monday through Thursday with special editions Fridays. And check out collegian.com anytime for all the latest updates. News, sports, entertainment, opinion, and more. The Rocky Mountain Collegian, serving Colorado State since 1891.
College Avenue has been your student magazine for the last 10 years. College Avenue prints once a month, covering topics that are relevant to the CSU and Fort Collins community. We also print special editions like the graduation guides at the end of each semester, the best of CSU each fall, and the orientation guide each summer. Look for us on racks around campus, off campus, or online at collegian.com under the College Avenue tab.
Last month, CSU students had their semester drag show titled Queerly Ever After.
This fairy tale themed drag show was held in the Laurie Student Center Ballroom, featuring not only CSU students but professional drag performers from all over Colorado. We're honored to have drag queen performer Delray Echohawk. Welcome, Delray.
Thank you for having me.
So how did you get involved with the drag show at CSU?
So I first attended the CSU drag show 2 years ago in the fall, and that was the first drag show I've ever seen, and I absolutely loved it. The following semester, I volunteered as one of our volunteers. And
ooh, I like that.
Yeah, we love puns, especially with queer. And then that following semester, I was elected as one of our drag show co-chairs, and I've been involved, and that was last fall.
Nice. And how much work would you say takes to put together this drag show?
It takes a lot of work. Me and my co-chair, Andy, put in a lot of work beforehand. We started planning this drag show, depending on what you call, depending on many things. We first ordered, reserved the ballroom all the way back in February. And then ever since summer, we've been working on finding people and making sure it's all paid for and it goes well.
Nice.
What got you started in drag?
So again, it was the CSU drag show. My first time fully in drag was during the last spring show. I performed with some of my really close friends, and I went out in full drag and had a total blast.
Nice.
And so when you guys are performing, are you dancing? Are you singing? Are you lip singing? Because I think I've been to a drag show once, and it's kind of like a mix of all of it.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of dancing and a lot of singing. People really love the dancing, and most folks do end up lip syncing, but there are certain people who do have really great voices and love to sing during their performance.
What's your favorite part?
I love the dancing, and I love the heels.
You love the heels?
I love the heels. How long
does it take you to get ready?
So this took me probably about 2 hours and 30 minutes to put on.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a lot of fun, though. It's it takes time and it takes a lot of practice.
Do you have any, like, I guess, advice for people if they want to get involved with the CSU drag show here?
I think just reaching out to me and kind of keeping an eye out for whatever, you know, when we start posting flyers and posters for it, to keep an eye out and, you know, email the drag show email as they feel comfortable.
Okay. And is it mainly all CSU students who participate in the event, or is it just people from everywhere or generally?
So this semester, about 16 of our performances were CSU students, and eight performances were from people from all around Colorado, especially Fort Collins.
Do you have any sort of show idol, I guess, that someone that when you first started getting into drag that you're like, oh my gosh, they are so great?
I do not have anyone in particular, but I've been really inspired by all the Fort Collins queens here.
Okay.
We have a small little community up here, and it's far from Denver, and it's definitely very unique, and I love everything they do.
And I was just going to ask real quick, outside of like the CSU drag show, is there other places that that drag goes on in Fort Collins?
Yeah, so the Whiskey has their drag nights hosted by Alana or Natalia, typically, as far as I'm aware. The first Saturday, and then our bar has Jessica Lahore's Lahore House every second Friday.
I think she was on here last semester, if I'm right.
Yep, she definitely was.
Very beautiful. You guys are both very beautiful.
Thank you.
And That's we appreciate incredible. You coming in. And yeah, thank you. We hope to see you next year in the show. Are you going to be in the show?
Yes, I'll be in next semester's show, April 1st.
April 1st
nice.
Of the spring
we'll
semester.
We'll
yes, we will plan on being there then.
Awesome.
And coming up, we'll take a look at a new sold-out show at the UCA and also some new films with Frank.
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
That's why we're here. We're free and here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with attendance. Gary, financial aid forms. Picking a college, man. You and us go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Go to GetSchooled.com.
Don't worry. 74 people were picked before me in the NFL draft.
To fight childhood obesity, United Way and the NFL are helping kids play at least 60 minutes a day.
Okay, time for the team obstacle course. Yay!
What this place needs is more healthy kids. To get involved or donate, go to unitedway.org/play60.
Now I get it.
Okay, Rams, it was a little extra chilly out today, I must say. And I feel a cold coming on. I was kind of complaining about that earlier that I'm starting to feel a little bit of a sore throat.
Well, lucky for you, Frank has some new films you can stay inside and stay in the warm coziness of your home and watch the movies. Check it out.
What is up, Rams? I am Frank Conley, and I know you are recovering from last night's results, but I'm here to show you there is still hope for 2017. We have a lot to cover tonight, so let's get started. We are starting off with the bittersweet return of the Wolverine series. Logan is an adaptation of the comic Old Man Logan and will take place after Days of Future Past. The film follows an aged Logan as his powers start to fade and Professor X as they try to protect a young girl who is very similar to Logan. Hugh Jackman has said that this will be the last X-Men film that he will be a part of. Patrick Stewart is reprising his role as Professor X, and Daphne Keene will play the young mutant Laura. Logan comes out March 3rd. Moving from one franchise to another, DC has released a new trailer for Wonder Woman. Taking place during World War I, an immortal Amazonian princess is inspired by a crashed U.S. pilot, Steve Taylor, to leave her island and help end the war. Gal Gadot, Wonder Woman's actress, said that this will be a different, more naive and idealist Wonder Woman than the one we saw in Batman vs. Superman. DC has been having a really hard time lately, as their last two films have been met with poor reviews. Will Wonder Woman bring DC back to the forefront? You can find out June 2nd. He's inspired you to act, to chase your dreams, to just do it. Yep, Shia LaBeouf has returned with his new movie, Man Down. LaBeouf's character, Gabriel Drummer, returns to the U.S. from a tour in Afghanistan, only to find his wife and son to be missing. Now, why Shia LaBeouf has been known to media for his eccentric personality, he has shown that he could play serious and heavy parts. I don't know if it's just the war genre itself, but I really do have faith that Shia LaBeouf will be able to play this part well. You can decide for yourself December 2nd. Continuing with the war theme, we have the French-American-German film Renegades. From the same people that brought you The Expendables and Taken, not much has been released about this 2017 film. What we do know is a group of Navy SEALs dives into a Bosnian lake to uncover a hidden stash of gold in an underwater city that the Nazis raided. The film stars J.K. Simmons and Sullivan Stapleton as the leads, and if the creators of Taken and The Expendables are working on this, this should be an edge-of-the-seat thriller. Renegades comes out February 3rd. With all that in mind, you're going to want to head to your local movie theater and check out these movies when they release.
If movies are not your cup of tea, then maybe you should head out to the University Center of the Arts this weekend for its new play, Noises Off. Entertainment reporter Nicole Hines, who's my good friend, got to go behind the scenes and during their rehearsals.
I'm Nicole Hines, and I'm here with Nicole Conklin, who is one of the stars of the new play, Noises Off, that is coming out. So would you just tell me a little bit about your play that is happening?
Yeah, so the show is called Noises Off, and it's considered a farce, which is a really complex comedy. It means that there's a lot of chaos, and the timing is really insane. And it's an old show. It's been around for a while, but it's a fabulous show. A lot of people know it, so I'm hoping that a lot of people come and see it. And it's just a really good time, except it's very exhausting.
So your character, you play?
I play Belinda Blair, who is playing a character in the show, which is in the show, and she plays Flavia. So I'm two characters, if you will.
Now, weird question, do you see like yourself sort of in your character at all?
Absolutely. So Belinda's very caring, and she's like the cheerleader. She wants to make sure everything goes well. And as the show progresses, she tries to keep everything together, and then eventually she's just like, all right, here we are. And it's kind of funny because I definitely can be like that. But I definitely see myself trying to be the cheerleader and keeping people happy and yeah.
And what are you most excited for opening night?
Ooh, I'm excited to just get in front of an audience because hearing the laughter adds a whole new element. Because the jokes, they're not so funny to us anymore because we're just so in the zone and it's kind of our reality. But when you hear people laugh, you're like, oh, that's kind of funny. And then it just has this whole new energy.
Well, thank you for joining us here, and if you guys haven't bought your tickets yet, go buy tickets for Noises Off.
Yes.
It's gonna be really good.
Everyone should just go check it out. The play opens November 11th at 7:30 at night. The first night is already sold out, so if you have not gotten your tickets yet, you can purchase them at csuarttix.com.
I want to go to that.
I think it'll be awesome. Yeah, and Nicole, so, I mean, she's a talented weather host and entertainment host. So
she just does everything.
Like, she's just Miss Fabulous. And she rides horses and she has a beautiful corgi.
Oh, she does?
Yeah,
a corgi?
Yes, she rides horses. I forgot.
Oh my gosh.
She's wonderful.
Hey.
Well, when we come back, we'll take a look at fall cleanup that happened this past Saturday, as well as some strange news.
Don't worry, 74 people were picked before me in the NFL draft.
To fight childhood obesity, United Way and the NFL are helping kids play at least 60 minutes a day.
Okay, time for the team obstacle course. Yay!
What this place needs is more healthy kids. To get involved or donate, go to unitedway.org/play60.
Now I get it.
a redhead staring contest? You still got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
Okay, those deer commercials, they crack me up.
That was hilarious.
But anyways, in the world and its forever funny stories, then how about you start us off with some strange news?
Strange news, strange news.
The future of coffee is here, and I don't know how I feel about it, honestly. These cubes contain the caffeine of a coffee would have with a relaxing feeling of green tea. One cube packs half a cup of coffee but gives you a more focused feeling instead of being jittery. Go cubes! Come in packs. These cubes come in packs of four. The effect they have usually lasts between 4 to 6 hours. I might have to try these out during my next binge watching season of Game of Thrones or Westworld. West show.
Last week, a squirrel caused a commotion in a Florida senior center located in Deltona. Look at their squirrel. The animal began its attack outside of the building and then made its way indoors, injuring 3 total people. With all the squirrels that are roaming around our Fort Collins campus, we need to watch our backs, Ram family, because these squirrels, they're dangerous and they're coming after us. When interviewed by the police, the squirrel commented, "Who run the world? Squirrels."
Who run the world? Squirrels. An aspiring actor needed a quick way to make money and found a way to walk towards success. At $7 a mile, Chuck McCarthy will walk with anyone who wants a friend. Aw. He states he is promoting a sense of security and provides some company when it's needed. The future is bright, and he hopes to start an app like Uber to grow his business. The real question is, why did I not think of this?
We all know that in order to get a job, you need a resume. I'm going through that right now with graduation coming up, and a portfolio that stands out from the rest. A 27-year-old photographer and game artist from Pakistan took things to a whole new level. His resume is 28 pages long and looks exactly like a magazine. It actually sounds kind of cool. He placed a picture of him on the front with keywords surrounding him. Now, I'm graduating in a few weeks, like I said, and I thought that I was very well prepared, but I guess I could add a few more pages to be a little more prepared. If these are the type of people I'm going to be competing against, I need to step up my game. Okay, so we discussed fall cleanup earlier, Vinny, and you have no idea, but I made a little funny video of you doing your own fall cleanup.
Oh, here we go.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Infield reporter Vincenzo Sangline here. Approach a pile like of this great size. You want to be careful. This is getting pretty rough. This is just magical and wonderful in every way.
Oh, that was cute. But we're even cuter now with our little hats on.
Yeah, I'm on.
So we need to tell everybody something that's happening. So obviously, I'm graduating. And Vinny, what are you doing?
I'm not graduating, but as the appearance of my hat tells you, I'm actually moving to Jamaica.
Yep. And what are you doing there?
I'm a geologist, first of all,
yes.
So I'm going to check out some sandy beaches, you know, study the sedimentary environments.
Can you believe he's a geologist? You'd think that he was a journalism student, right?
Yeah, man. Yeah.
But anyways, so that's why he's wearing his little Rasta hat.
I know.
And
you're graduating.
I know,
that would be
I'm so,
so
excited.
Sad that
I graduate in December, December 17th. I am counting down the days. I've enjoyed and loved my time here at CSU, but I am ready for my next journey in life. And that's why I thought my little high school, Highlands Ranch, I put my tassel to the
HR.
Other side because this is my last CTV show.
Oh, no.
She's sad.
I'm going to miss you so much.
I'm going to miss you so
it's
much.
Be like losing a leg.
A full leg?
A full one.
Well, I guess we're both going to lose a limb for the rest of our lives.
Right.
No, we'll rekindle somewhere.
Your leg.
But it's been a wonderful time here at CSU, like I said, and I just want to say thank you to my Ram Life family and everyone that has helped so much with this Ram Life show. And not even that, when I started out here as a entertainment host last semester, and Vinny would appear on it all the time. I'm starting to get goosebumps. Get a
this has all happened because of you, honestly. Thanks. We're all here, and you've done an amazing job. Oh, way to do it.
We'll see. And for next semester, the Ram Life show will continue on, because we'll both be gone. But they will be holding auditions at some point. We just don't know when yet. So stay tuned to the other CTV shows if you are interested in auditioning for Ram Life Entertainment or any positions on our CTV channel. But anyways.
Well, it's been a great semester. And
thank you to everyone. And study hard for finals. Have a good Thanksgiving break.
Feeling hot, hot, hot.
And enjoy. And I have to say this. Out of everything, I have to tell you guys, enjoy your time here at CSU, because it flies by. I'm getting a little emotional, but
it goes by fast.
School comes to an end quick, and then you got adult life coming. So enjoy it while you can, and have a wonderful night. And thank you, Vinny, for everything. I love
you. Thanks. One love.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.